Hi everyone, this is Rusty Dog. Welcome to the second part of taking a look at 2.2. What you're looking at is Saturn. And we are on one of its moons, Enceladus. And if you look at my coordinates, 69.8766, 37.9020. Let's take a look outside. Yeah, plenty of orange dots, and these are geysers. Now I was expecting something a little bit more, well, like that, but a lot higher. But maybe we need to get closer in. There's another one there. No, there's two there. They look like warts or blisters on the surface of the planet. We've got another one there, look. Let's see if we can. Now I don't have an SRV, so I'm gonna do my best here, and I'm gonna leave you guys to get your SRVs out and take a look at these. So we've got this one. So let's go in and have a look as best we can. So I can get down pretty close. Well, that's as far as I can go downwards, unless try not to make too much of a dog dinner of this. Okay, so that's what I wanted. I want to get lower down. So I've sort of landed like a little bit upside down. Yeah, doesn't surprise me that I'm underneath. And the way to get out is that way. So we're going to see quite an unusual shot here, I would imagine. Which that's the shot I wanted. So, yeah, I can probably get right close in now, to be honest. So there we have a geyser. Looks pretty cool. Now I was around, somebody gave me the wrong coordinates, and I couldn't see a bloody thing. But finally I got one that was updated. So this is kind of what to expect, what to look for. I don't know whether my camera's going to allow me enough range to get to this next one, but I'm assuming that they're all going to be roughly the same. Oh, it will let me. So, oh, we're just about inside it there. I'm assuming there are varying heights and stuff like that, but you can see there's quite a few scattered around here, so as long as you can get near these coordinates, you can take your pick. This one looks particularly, the one I'm looking at looks particularly active though. It's spitting out all the embers and stuff. And has to be said to look pretty cool. Okay, in the process of me coming here, I learned how to use the coordinates and how to navigate, and I'm going to impart that information to you. If there are any long pauses between my speech, it's because I'm taking the mic off while I sneeze. Yeah. I like that you can see here, you can see just on the outside, it looks like it's a bit hot there. I quite like that effect. Seems to move around with the camera. Don't worry about the ship. The ship's fine. It's not actually touching anything, is it? I don't know if it is or not. But yeah, they've got warnings going off inside the cockpit. So it'll be nice to jump over one in an SRV, of course. But maybe that's for another day. I can come back here. So, how do you get here? Right. When I was doing my live stream, there was people telling me this, and I was kind of understanding about going to 90 degrees and 180 degrees and stuff like that, but I wasn't 100% understanding what they were meaning. But now I do. Now I understand exactly what these guys were trying to tell me, and so here we go. Okay, so you want to try and fly somewhere close to the coordinates. So when you're coming in to the planet and you go into you're orbiting around the planet, don't let it get into glide. When you're in orbital cruise, be there or thereabouts where the coordinates are, just to save yourself time. Because the second part of this, where you're moving the coordinates here like this, you see the coordinates moving, they are what I'm going to be calling micro movements. You're going to be doing a few of those, so you want to cut down on the amount of time you're doing that as much as possible. So get as close to the coordinates as you can, so that when you enter glide, come out of glide, you're not that far away. Okay, so you've been given a set of coordinates, a latitude and a longitude. Latitude on the top, longitude on the bottom. So how do we do it? Well, you can see my compass is now set to zero at the top there. So if I thrust forward only, you'll see that that moves the longitude. If I thrust in reverse, it moves it backwards. But you'll also notice that the latitude isn't moving at all. The latitude only moves when you're pointing at 90 degrees or 270 degrees, or if you thrust sideways. So you can either thrust sideways or move 90 degrees. So let's say I'm just going to boost over here for a second, just so that I'm out the way of those dodgy geysers. And I want the ship to come to a rest while I'm at 0 degrees at the top. There we go. So I'm looking for 69.8766, 37.9020. So you can choose which one you want to do first. As I'm pointing at zero, it looks like I'm going to be doing longitude first, the bottom number. 0 and 180 will move the bottom number. 90 and 270 moves the top number. So let's try and get the ship leveled out as well. Also, that will help. And if we can get that to zero, make sure you're a decent amount off the ground so you're not going to hit anything. And backwards will move the numbers down. Forwards will move the numbers up. So we need to go backwards because we need to get to 37.3. If this is too slow for you, you can always turn the ship round to point at 180 and then maybe use your main engines or even boost. But right now all I need are micro movements because I'm very, very close here. So 39.9020. It doesn't have to be bang on to the 0.000, but 39.90 should do it. The 20s suit kind of superfluous, but it depends how much of a perfectionist you are. Okay, so we're into the 37.9s. So 37.90 coming up. For the purpose of this demonstration, we will try and nail it. So we've gone a little bit too far. And I want to go a bit forward to 1920. And there it is. Now, if I want to do the latitude in the same way, the top number, I can just turn my ship 90 degrees or 270 degrees, or I can just use my side thrusters. And we want to go to 69.8766. Now I know I'm not too far away, so I'm going to do it this way. So left brings the number down, right takes the number up, and we want to go up. Now it is possible that the bottom number will move very, very slightly. As long as you're pointing in one of the absolute directions, 0, 90, 180, 270, I wouldn't worry about it too much at this stage. So let's just go to 69.8766. Using the side thrusters. So if anybody was confused about how to nail this, then I'm hoping to clear the clouds for you. If not, then that means I'm probably the only person in the galaxy that didn't know this. So there we go, we've got 89. Now if you want to go to 37.9020 again, you can just nip it forward back again. You can nip it forward again. But you're pretty much there. As you can see, I'm making very, very tiny movements. You don't need to be this accurate, really. Hold on, I need to go to 66. But I'm just, for the purpose of this video. Okay. And I think if I just go there, it's being very finicky. There we go. Oh, okay. There we go. We've nailed exactly the coordinates now that we were given. So now we can just use the down thruster. If it goes off by a thousandth of a degree, I seriously do not care. So down we go. And what you need to do, obviously, is pull out the landing gear and get a landing spot. Well, pretty much as close as you can possibly get. Oh, we've got a landing right here. I wasn't expecting that. And believe me, you're close enough now. I haven't landed in the spot that's got the best view. There's a geyser there, though. It's changed its mind now, so we're just going to... Oh, there we go. Oh, that'll do. Now, I am going to land, because I want to show you something. It doesn't look like it wants to let me land. So I'm going to try going up a bit and going back. There's that geyser look on the right. Because I know I'm in the general area anyway. Okay, we're down. You can see that geyser there. I think that's probably the one that we were looking at before. Over there. And now you can just drop your SRV and go on a little journey and have a look around. Perfect. Alright, so the other thing that's in 2.2, of course, is the new launch sequence when you're lifting off. So let's do that. There we go. And we're only a little way up, but you can see that these geysers are very hard to spot from the air. I mean, you have to look at them as little blisters, because the actual orangey fire, it's very difficult to spot. We're 300 and odd meters up, and they're very difficult, so you're probably going to be relying on the forum. Now that looks a big one, doesn't it? I think the ones that are probably lit up the most from the air are probably the ones we want to be looking at. Oh, there's quite a lot of them around here. There really is a lot, so you really don't need to nail the coordinates here exactly, because in this particular place there are loads of them scattered everywhere around. Now I've got full power to shields because I tend to come in just a little bit too fast. And turn the lights off so we get a better effect. So this is what to expect, guys. This one looks like it's a little bit angry. I wonder if flying over it will do anything. We're at 34% heat. Now we're on top of it. Oh, the heat has gone down. 32% now. It's cooling my ship off. Okay, and we have another one here. So it seems that I'm okay without the SRV. Okay, so I've also been given a set of coordinates for the Fumaroles, which is on another planet in this solar system. So using my compass method, I'm going to attempt to find that and show it to you. I suspect it's going to be a little more difficult to track down because they're not as visual, but it's this one, Actaea, and it seems to be quite a way out, 22,000, and that just looks like a very badly peeled potato. So this is where we want to go, and yeah, I'll be back when I'm there, and hopefully it'll be on the bright side. I'm actually kind of happy that this was on the dark side at the moment, because it's given more of an effect to the geysers, so I think we got it here just at the right time. Okay, see you in a bit. Right then, here we are approaching Actaea. That's how I'm going to pronounce it. And we're going to see if we can get to the coordinates we need to get to. Now, I have made some changes since you've been gone. The ASP has now been painted in white. Oh, and I fitted an SRV. Yeah. So now it's got an SRV. So the coordinates we need to go to are 10 and minus 12. The point, anything that's point blah blah blah, I'm not bothered about. Not yet. Just 10 and minus 12. So the best thing is to approach. Oh, please don't be on the dark side. Let's go to the light side and ask the universe to please keep the fumaroles on this side. It's not going to matter. I've got a headlight with SRVs and stuff, so it's not really. I've got a headlight with SRVs. Nobody else I know has got a headlight with SRVs. I think I'm the only person to have such a thing. I also have an SRV with headlights, so yeah. Alright, so we can basically do the same system from the air, except for the fact that the compass doesn't kick in. But if I'm going to 10 then, as you can see, and then I want to dramatically switch. Now, I don't know how the hell anybody found fumaroles. I understand that there's a planet when it tells you, we do want to get into the drop zone here. Yes, it's got water geysers. Like this one says it has water geysers as well. But I'm going to go to the minus 12 first, I think. It's got water geysers as well. But this one says water geysers. It mentions nothing about fumaroles. So how the hell anybody found that, I don't know. Alright, so there's minus 12-ish. So now I need to be going the other way. Minus 12 and 10, so I need to be going the other way. I don't know which way 90 degrees is. It doesn't tell me. I'm trying to keep it in the blue here to keep the speed up. So that's going down, that's going up. I think I'm just going to drop it right here. So I'm going to descend here. Wow! Is it just me, or does that look like it's going to make some awesome canyon racing? I have to remember this place and bring my courier here for some well-needed stretching of legs. Oh, that looks like it's going to be fun. Okay, well, we're at minus 12 anyway, so at least it's something. How anybody spotted this, I cannot even begin to fathom. So, we're looking for minus 12.8. So now that we have... now that we have come out of glide, let's go into zero and we'll just tilt the ship around. Oh, come on. It would be nice to have little tiny marks. Oh, well, we have some. I can just barely see them. There we go. All right, so we're at zero. So we know that zero operates the front and back. And we know if we go that way, it goes backwards. And if it goes backwards, we go forwards. We should be facing the other way, really. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to just switch to the side and pull around to 180 degrees. We are quite a bit off at the moment, but at least I'm going to show you how to find this, which may take up a bit more time on the video, but at least probably you all know this already, but and I was just the last one to find out. Oh, come on, hit 180. Come on. Unbelievable. I can't make it hit 180. There we go. Right then. So, 12.8. I can't read my own writing. 12.8614. So, I'm just going to use the main engines. No, don't, how did you get there? Right, 12.8614. And I think I better slow it down now. I'm not going to get this exactly on because it doesn't need to be, because it's going to lose its it's going to lose out a little bit later on. So 12.8 for now will be quite sufficient, thank you. Okay, so we're okay there. So now I'm going to change back to 90 degrees and I'm just going to yaw my way there. And there we go. And if I thrust forward now, it's going up and I need it to go down. So 270 degrees it is. I have to remember which way does positive and which way does negative. So 270 is negative on the top, 90 degrees positive on the top. Yeah, okay, I'll remember that now. No, I won't. You know I won't. We all know I won't remember it. I'll have to write it down. So 270 degrees, and I think I'm going to be using boost here. So 270 and boost. And we need to go all the way down to 10.1. It might prove to be better to gain height and maybe do this in orbital cruise. It depends how many boosts this is going to be. Just concentrating on keeping it at 270. It is going to take a short while. I'll be back when we're there. Okay, so we've made some progress. You can see this kind of a... it's like I'm... Fantastic Voyage or something. And this is... I'm probing around somebody's brain here. So I'm just trying to get the top coordinate to go to 10.1. And then I think we can find a place to land. Which looks like it might be a little bit tricky. There's not going to be a lot of parking spaces around here, but I'm not going to let that deter me. Now I am, because I'm pointing the arse of the ship upwards. I've been increasing my altitude ever since. So I definitely need to bring that down. And the gravity here is reporting 0.00, which I've never seen before. So I'm just going to bring this thing in. In fact, if I took flight assist off, then I should stay exactly where I am. It'd be interesting to see that. I'm not buying that 0.00. So I'm going to just bring the ship to a complete stop, as opposed to a partial stop.
Flight assist off.
I am staying where I am. So I'll use that just to maintain my speed, my drop speed. There's no gravity here whatsoever. I'm in some weird part of the universe. Okay, so as long as my bottom figure still says 12.8, I'm fairly happy with that. I kind of know what I'm looking for. I've seen a screenshot, so I'm sort of aware of what I'm looking for, and just hoping that there isn't a great big mountain behind me. So 10, the exact figure, is probably that thing. I'm guessing it does show up as a point of interest. That was a very small point of interest. I'm kind of curious to take a look at that, to be honest. That could be exactly the one we're after anyway. So 10.1, the top coordinate, guys, is 10.1334. The bottom is -12.8614, and it could be that blue dot. But I want to just drop down my I think it is that blue dot, to be honest, because if I go this way, 8614, it's exactly that. It is exactly that. Alright, but I'm not going to go by the blue dot because I have to, let me just zero this, because I have to come down to an altitude that makes that blue circle go away. Oops, I just put rear thrusters on there when I should have been descending. But that's a very, very specific spot, isn't it? If I can get a parking space anywhere near here, this is going to be a crash landing. Alright, let's have a look where we are then. So 10.1334. I am very, very close now.
Scan detected.
Yeah, the usual. 10.1334, whatever, 335. And 10.8614. So we just need to swivel along this way. So it's here. Now the question is, look at that, even with lights on, nothing's happening. The question is, can we get parked? You gotta be kidding, really? Right here? That's beautiful. We're right in the cavern. Brain wanted to say cavern, rogue brain wanted to say canyon, and it came up with canyon. Well, I don't know what the hell it was trying to come out with there, but anyway, let's land here. And we've got the SRV. Which I haven't plugged in my controller for, but no matter. I'm going to do that right now. Now I sort of know what I'm looking for. It's not working. My controller's not working. Dear Frontier, is this because of me not plugging it in initially, or is it because the keybinds are not available in the beta? I'm going to set it up and I'll be back. Right, we're in the ship. We're in the SRV and we're ready to go. Now, what I don't know is if the fumaroles are going to show up here as anything on this on the sensors. I don't think so. So let's see if we can get to the exact coordinates with the SRV then. And my lights are on full whack here, so 10.1334. I suppose we'd better use the same system here, so I'm just going to go to zero. I can't go sideways with this thing. So 10.1 and 12.8614. Okay, so we couldn't be more in the wrong direction. 12.8614. Which means I probably should be facing the other way. And I hope my ASP isn't sitting on. I'm gonna try this button. Yeah. If you go into the controls now, there's a single button you can press, you can assign, to dismiss the ship without going through the without going through here. It's brilliant. Of course, the same button will recall the ship. So minus 12.8614. So let's get there. I do have a screenshot I can refer to. Okay. Come on back. Right, 86. I just want to get it exactly right. So, and the next one is 10.1334. So I'm going to need to face 90 degrees or 180 degrees. And I need 10.1334. Which is backwards. But it's going to be such a short distance. So I'm guessing these coordinates are where the SRV should be. And we'll get out and have a look in a minute. No, you can't get out, but you know what I mean. You know what I mean. We'll use the external camera. Wouldn't it be nice to be able to fire off one of those drones? Just to fire off a drone and take a look. So which direction this is going to be in? It's extremely dark. I really can't see anything. So I think we should just scout around the area. I'm going to have a quick look at the screenshot. 1 second. And it doesn't really give much away. I'm just looking for a rock formation, basically, that's got some smooth bits on it. And judging by the screenshot, it's probably not worth my time. But we're going to try and see it anyway. I don't know, I don't even know what a fumarole is. I thought that was a procession where you go and bury dead people. Turns out it's not. I mean, are they these things? I've never seen these formations before. So I'm assuming this is it. Because these are all different formations, so I'm guessing this is what we're looking for. I mean, what is this exactly? Does it do anything? Is this what we're looking for? Can we have a look inside? There isn't anything inside, is there really? It's just three rocks in a pyramid formation. That can't be it. Is that all it is? don't think that's even worth a headline, but I suppose... Yeah, I mean, it is something different. It's certainly not what I was seeing in the screenshot. I've just had a little look online. It turns out that they could be them, but they're inactive ones, because they're supposed to be higher and have gases coming out of them. They are volcanic openings, but these look pretty inactive to me. What do we have here? Yeah, well, trust me to find a coordinates of some that are inactive. Can you pick those up? I don't know. Come on, ship. I'm trying to... We must be on a really big slope here because I can't move this ship. Come on! Well, there's some crystalline fragments there, which if I can... if I can ever get there again, I'll put the handbrake on and see if I can show you. I'm not really having too much success. I'm just trying to find a different route to see it. Oh, come on, come on! See, it looks like we're in a... we're straight, but we are far from it, as you can see on the sensor there. Well, you can't pick it up. I have no idea what's down here. Oh yeah, this is where I've just been. I thought I was going over the other side. But yeah, the other ones look like... the ones I've seen in the screenshot looks like a mini volcano. You know, like a very small, tiny, itsy-bitsy one with gas coming out. But these are pretty much the exact coordinates I was given. Let's take a look out and see if we can have a look at this crystalline entity thing, whatever it is. So there we go. We can't pick those up. There doesn't appear to be the remnants of a big hole into the center of the magma of the Earth, or the planet there. So... let's have a scout around. I'm not seeing smoke from anywhere, and it's a shame that this is on the dark side. I'm just seeing these things, and fumaroles apparently do look quite a bit different. They look like the geysers, actually. Only a bit more stony. Let's have a look down here. Is this where I've come from? We'll find out. Thanks to tire marks. I mean, is that something? I don't even know. There's no volcanic activity on these things. I can't get out of here. I'm just going to bring the ship back anyway. Maybe I'll have better look scouting scouting in the ship, where I don't have the restrictions of things like hills and the ground. Please don't land up there. I'll stand back while you land. Just land close by and I will be happy. It seems I haven't... Yes, I have found the targeting button. I just can't target my ship right now. Okay. Oh, don't tell me you've gone up there. Oh, you doozy. No, that's no good. Right. I'll be back. Right, well, it would seem that those fumaroles might... The ones I looked at may or may not have been, but I'm getting the impression that you don't see the wispy smoke stuff unless it's daytime, and it definitely wasn't daytime. Also, that people are really having a tough time finding these things. So I'm going to give this a miss for now. I'm not going to spend any more time on this, and I'm going to move on to the next thing. So let's do that. Okay, so here we are at Jameson in the Beluga, which I have just re-outfitted. I wanted to show you the passenger missions, but I don't think that's going to happen because the game is unstable. I've had three crashes to desktop already in the passenger lounge, and not only that, for me right now the missions aren't worth it. They're either too far or too near, and either way they just don't pay enough. Let's go into outfitting. I think the distance to reward needs to be tweaked. So as you know from before, I've got twin beams, two multi-cannons and a seeker missile pack here. Utilities, 2-point defense, 3-point defense, shield booster, heat sink and a chaff. Pretty well covered all the bases on that one. Core, I wonder what fitting the military grade would do. It drops my jump range down to 19 from 21. That's quite significant. Boost speed, top speed, 213, 299, 209. That's not a big deal for me. So the biggest issue there is jump range, but I get a 212% hull boost. In the 2.2 final, this is probably something I would consider. But in the beta, it doesn't matter. Because if I get destroyed, it doesn't matter. Because all the destructions don't count for anything. So, not bothered. Everything here, apart from life support and sensors, are A-rated. If you are doing passenger missions, I would say you need a grade 5 FSD increase here. You just do the best you can get to, because you need to bring down the amount of jumps as much as you possibly can. And also, here's another problem. You need what is technically termed as a kick-ass fuel scoop. And the problem is, I would say anyway, at least a grade 5, well, grade 4, I mean, I don't know what the time on this is going to be to fill that up. Scoop rate 0.34, I don't know how long that's going to take. But if you look at ships such as Corvette, Anaconda, stuff like that, you can fit class 5, class 6 fuel scoops. Not with this. It won't let you have them. And I don't know why. If I go to three here, now you note I've already got a fuel scoop fitted, but it already offers me an alternative here. It won't let me fit one because I've already got one fitted, but it's there in the shop waiting to be bought. If I wanted to go to grade class 5, you'll see that there's just these three. There's no scoop, there's no nothing else. 6 the same. It's like me trying to scratch my head over why a fighter hangar has to go in to a slot one above its grade. Its class. Grade, class. You can, if you, this is a class 6 slot, you click it, you got to browse, you got to fight the hangers, and there is a class 6 one. But you got a class 5. The difference is this holds two vehicles, pointless right now though, and this holds unless one gets destroyed, I suppose, but then you need two pilots. So, yeah, you've got two ships or one ship. Alright, so you've got 5 or 6 to choose from. So it would make sense to choose this 6-1 for this slot. But if we come down to 5, again, no fighter hangar available. And you'll notice in the cabins, the 5s in the 6, the 4s in the 5s, the 4 in the 5. I'm losing every single time because you can't get a class 6 luxury, you can't get a class 5 business, and you can't get a class 5 economy. So the type of cabin classes that are available don't seem to gel well with the class slots available in the Beluga. You know, this is a ship that's purpose-built for passenger missions, so I kind of think these numbers should match what the Beluga's capable of. Maybe they'll fit better in an Orca, I don't know. But I just feel like I'm losing out here. I suppose it's like the Discovery scanners. They're only class 1s because they only need to be. So it could be that. Let me see if I can change this for an advanced Discovery scanner. Yeah, I'm not losing any megawatts or whatever. So, okay, back to the passenger lounge then. It's probably going to crash, but we'll see. Going into the passenger lounge is absolutely fine. Now we've got missions here. So look, 21,000 to go one jump. If you can be bothered, go for it. This one, double the money because you might get some trouble. Here, 45 million. To go 22,000 light years to Jax. For me, that's not worth it. It's a nice amount of money, but I'm guessing if you're lower ranked and in an Orca, you probably won't get that mission. I don't know. 7 million to go 1,600 light years. This mission here, that's about, in my Beluga now with an A-rated FSD drive, and the weight and everything with my jump range that I've got, this is about 70 jumps to get there, and therefore 70 back. So 140 jumps for 3.6 million. That's not economically worth it for me at all. I could spend the time it takes to do that. I could spend that in a combat zone and make more money. It's really not worth it. So they're either 12 light years or they're 1,000 light years. There doesn't seem, or 22,000. I'm not seeing in betweens. I'm seeing the odd 6,000, 7,000. It's just not varied enough. It's just not varied enough. Now, to make it crash, I used to click on these. And there we go, it's just crashed again. So, it's not working. So this screen's going to black out any moment. Yeah, doesn't work. It's broken. So I can't show you this. So let's move on to something else.